Have you ever felt lost trying to come up with the perfect prompt for ChatGPT? Well, not any longer. In this video, I will show you an app that you can use on top of your ChatGPT in order to visualize your conversation as a graph, see the main ideas inside, how they're related to one another, but most importantly, identify the gaps, so the topics that you're not yet connecting, and then use those gaps to generate interesting research questions that can lead you to new ideas. So if you're interested, keep watching and I will demonstrate how it works. Also a little bit about myself. I'm Dimitri. I'm the developer of this app. It's called InfraNodus. I've been working in the field of AI for the last several years and I like using different tools and sharing my insights. So if you like this video, please also subscribe so that it gets recommended to other people interested in the same stuff. So let's jump right in. Here I have a conversation that I was having with my ChatGPT. It was about ecological thinking. And at some point, after a few responses, I reach a limit. I don't know what else I should ask it. So there, what I can do is to open the InfraNodus extension here. And what InfraNodus extension does is that it visualizes the conversation I'm having here as a graph, where the words in the conversation are the nodes and the co-occurrences are the connections between them, so that I can quickly see what are the main terms used in this conversation. So I see that there is a strong relation between ecological thinking, and by the way, it highlights relations, not only words, so that's why it's very useful. I also see that there's something on social impact, systems, and also sustainable practices. And that gives me like a good overview and a reminder of what this conversation was about. Now let's say I want to develop it further. The most effective way is to go into the gaps here. And what InfraNodus does is that it identifies the topics that are not yet well connected, that I didn't talk about in the same context in this particular conversation. And I can reload a few of them and, for example, find something that I find interesting. In this case, I like this gap between impact assessment and carbon neutrality. And then I can use the built-in AI to generate a question for this gap that will bridge this gap. So here it says, how can integrated policy frameworks be developed to assess and enhance the positive contributions of local materials in achieving carbon neutrality while promoting social and economic growth in communities? That's quite an interesting question. It combines both ecological thinking and social policies, maybe even politics a little bit. So what I can do, I can copy this question and then I can paste it to ChatGPT. I can make this window smaller and paste it to ChatGPT. And then what's going to happen is that ChatGPT obviously will try to answer this question and develop the conversation further. And once it answers this question, this graph here is going to be reloaded. It will take into account the answer of ChatGPT, what it just produced, recalculate everything and help me identify the new gaps in the conversation, the new relations, new ideas and so on. So let's see how that happens. So here it generates an answer. As soon as it's finished, the graph is regenerated and now I can see a new gap in the conversation that I can bridge. If I want, I can reload it. And usually I like to find gaps that are really further from each other as far from each other as possible. So for example, here, carbon innovation and sustainable practices. It means that ChatGPT is talking about those topics, but not really connecting them together. So I'm going to ask it to generate another question based on this gap. And here it takes those two topics and tries to come up with a new question. It says here, how can companies integrate innovative practices to establish measurable sustainability goals that align with carbon neutrality targets, thereby promoting long-term growth and ethical standards in development? So you see here, it's talking about how corporations can adopt those practices. And it's probably because it talked about it, but not in the same context. I can paste this question again, and then it's going to come up with a new answer. So that's how it works. You can also use it on a completely new conversation. So let's say I just want to start directly from zero. So I'm just going to start with an empty conversation here. As you can see, it just visualizes what I have, so I don't need it right now. And I'm going to try to talk about, let's say, I want to develop a new app for ChatGPT prompt engineering. Okay. And I'm going to open the extension now so that as soon as ChatGPT answers, it's going to visualize the results. So you see here, it's providing me some ideas about how I can launch it. And it's quite verbose. And here, I don't need to read the answer of ChatGPT. That's why I like it also, because sometimes it gives you this really long answers and maybe you just want to kind of start brainstorming. So you don't need to read through everything, but rather you can look into the main ideas. So for example, here, obviously, app is a big idea. And actually, let me remove this word because this is not so important for us. I'm just gonna click on concepts here, select app, and I'm gonna hide it from the graph so that I can see the context around it. And then I'm gonna go to the gaps and ask it to identify a gap. So for example, prompt engineering, native development. That's interesting, let's see what it's about. So I'm gonna generate a question based on that. And here it says, how can a mobile app leveraging ChatGPT prompt engineering optimize user experience through tailored templates while ensuring swift integration with frameworks like React Native and Flutter? So basically here it's proposing me, okay, you could make an app for prompt engineering for mobile that would have some kind of templates, but you also need to make it in a way that it would work on different devices, on iPhone, for example, and on Android. And these are the two frameworks that would work on both. So that can be an interesting question. I can paste it here and then go into the technical aspects of developing this app. On the other hand, I can, of course, also decide, okay, I don't actually just want to focus on the technical aspects. Maybe I want to focus more on how this app should actually work, right? So what I can do also is that I can ask this question from inside and from Nodus itself, in fact. So I can, let me get this word app in back in the app, and then I go into chat. And here it's telling me that it's going to use the context, in fact, that I have in this conversation. So I'm going to go to explore. Let me just deselect everything and reload it once again, because sometimes it needs to be reloaded to have the whole conversation in its memory, right? And then I go to ChatGPT here. So it has like its own ChatGPT, it's a chat. And then I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna check if the context is the whole graph. So I'm gonna click here. And as you can see, I have all the topics of the conversation as the context of this chat. And then I'm going to say, what could be this app about? How would it work specifically and be helpful to users? So I'm gonna ask this question. It's going to use the context of the graph to generate an answer. And here it says the app would focus on optimizing prompt engineering for users, offering customized templates and A/B testing features. It would provide real-time feedback to refine prompts and enhance user engagement while integrating smoothly with frameworks like React Native and Flutter. So here I have a summary of this conversation, which is great. I can paste it here and then develop this conversation further. Or what I can also do is, once I have this conversation and I have the main topics identified, I can look at these topics, I can extend this window and kind of look at them in detail. And for example, focus on something specific, like for instance here, analytics performance. And I can ask the system, okay, let's go in the chat and let's clear this conversation, check the context, it's only this topic. So, and then I will ask it how I can develop it further. So here it's just going to talk in relation to this topic that I selected, which is great. You see, here it says to further develop your app, consider integrating advanced analytic tools to track user behavior and template usage. This will help you identify gaps for improvement while ensuring an effective collaboration experience. So here it's great because I don't have to take the whole conversation. I can just focus on certain aspects that I find interesting, kind of like building blocks, and then send them back to the built-in chat or use them to generate interesting questions for my ChatGPT. So I can also just select this topic here and then generate a question, and then it's going to generate a question right based on this cluster which I selected, right? So I'm gonna click this. Here it's talking about cloud-based platforms and how they can be used. And then I'm kind of making ChatGPT think further, focusing on that very topic that I selected. So this is another really great feature of it, is that you can actually use the graph to focus on specific aspects of the conversation, which can be pretty useful and interesting, especially if you kind of have like a really long conversation and you don't want to talk about all the different aspects, but you only want to focus on some. You can even zoom in and select some specific topics like words. So for example, machine, let's see, machine, what else is connected to? Machine learning. So let's say machine learning models. That's interesting, so it's a bit more technical. Let's select this path and then we will try to generate a question based on this very path of machine learning. And here it's saying, how can the mobile app for ChatGPT prompt engineering integrate machine learning analysis with user feedback metrics to optimize template variations and enhance real-time user engagement? Great. So here it's telling me, okay, you could actually analyze user behavior, how they're using prompts in this mobile app, and then generate some more tools based on that. So I'm going to paste this question into ChatGPT. So I selected something I find interesting from the whole conversation without having to read through the whole thing. And then I asked it to generate me this idea. And here it's providing me the answer to my question. So let me just show you. Here I had a question, I believe. Yeah, here. How can a mobile app for ChatGPT? So, and here it's giving me the whole kind of almost like an article or a comprehensive guide. So it's giving me an architecture and workflow, data collection and storage, and so on. So you see here, it's pretty interesting because it already gave me a whole procedure on how I could actually develop this app. And this just happened in a few minutes, as you can see. So it's pretty amazing. As I say, you can use this graph just to focus on gaps. So if you don't want to use the graph, you can just go into gaps, generate some gaps, and then use the inside question feature. Or what you can also do is deselect everything and focus on specific topics like I did here, data analysis, content optimization, cloud performance, and so on. Or you can also select specific concepts that you find interesting, like here, templates and prompts. And here it shows you which connections are more relevant and prominent. So that can be interesting for you because maybe you want to combine them. But you can also combine things that are not connected. So for example, templates and prompts and let's say, something that it's not connected to, maybe Google, for example, and data, you know? So you can really create your own paths in this graph, and then based on those paths, generate interesting questions for ChatGPT or even ideas and summaries as well. So try it out. It's available on infranodus.com. If you go here into Infranodus, and then you go to the extension. So it's in the info section, and then you need to click on AI browser extension and you can download it for Chrome or for Firefox, and then just activate it and use it on top of ChatGPT. Try it out. And if you have any questions or comments, let me know and I'll be happy to help. Thank you.